Hello everyone, I hope you all are safe at your places. So today we are going to learn the next part, part 2 of pronouns. So I hope you all are ready, okay? So now let's get started. So in this part, we are going to talk about personal pronouns. See, there are three persons in the personal pronoun and this is the first type of pronoun. The first person, the second person and the third person. The first person is always the speaker, the second person is the listener, and the third person is always the subject about whom or what we are talking, okay? So, the first person is always I and we. When we talk about the singular one, it's I, and when we talk about the plural one, it's we. And there are three cases, nominative, objective, and the possessive one, okay? To nominative we call it subjective as well, and the objective one and the possessive one which shows possession. Objective case of I is me and possessive one is mine, and of we it's us and ours. Now let's talk about the second person to whom we are talking, okay? Singular and plural, both ways this is the you only, okay? And in the nominative and the objective case as well, when we talk about the possessive one, it's yours, both ways. Let's talk about the third person now. So, in singular, the third person, in nominative case, it is he, she, it. Objective one, her, him, it. And the possessive one, his, hers. Or we can say it's, okay? When we talk about the plural one, that's this is they, them, theirs. Okay? So, for all of these things, for all of these terms, there are certain rules. But firstly, let's have an example to understand this in a better way, okay? If I'm saying, मैं तुमसे उसके बारे में बात कर रही हूँ, okay? Here, मैं is the first person जो बात कर रही है, who's speaking here, okay? तुमसे, तुम, you is the second person to whom we are talking, okay? And उसके बारे में, उसके, that third person is the subject about whom I'm talking, okay? About whom I'm speaking. Hope it's clear now. So now let's know the rule one. A verb is always preceded by the nominative form of pronoun and followed by the objective form of it. And here I would like to add that nominative form is also known as the subjective form. Okay. So let's have an example. I teach him. Okay. I teach him. मैं उसे पढ़ाती हूँ. This is the active voice. Okay, here I is the subjective form, or we can say nominative one, and him is the objective form, and him is followed by the verb, okay, and I is before the verb. So we all have to know this, whether that is the active or the passive voice. As the second one says, he is taught by me, okay, again the me is followed by the verb and he is before the verb. I hope I'm clear here. Here I and he are the nominative forms of pronoun, and him and me are the objective one. Now let's talk about the second rule. See, if all the three persons or two out of the three persons come in a single sentence, then the order will be 2-3-1. Second person, third person, and then the first person, okay? Let's talk about the examples now. Tumhe, mujhe, aur usse exam ke liye padhna chahiye. You, second person, he, third person, and I, first person, shall study for the exam. I hope this is clear. Next one, मैंने और उसने अपना काम खत्म कर लिया है. He, third person, and I, first person, have finished our work. The third example, तुम, सीता और मैं बात नहीं कर रहे हैं. You, सीता, and I are not talking. So now let's talk about the rule number 3. If all the three persons or two out of three persons come in a single sentence and something wrong is talked about or some mistake done by the persons has been accepted, then the order will be 1-2-3, okay? Let's have an example. मैंने, उसने और तुमने यह गलती की. Here we are, you know, admitting our mistake. So, I, you and he have made this mistake. The next one. उसने और तुमने यह शैतानी की है. You and he have done this mischief. 2-3. the second person, and then the third one. Now let's talk about the rule number 4. It says if pronouns are in plural form, the order should be 1, 2, and 3. The first person, second person, and the third person. For instance, हमें तुम्हें और उन्हें अब खाना खा लेना चाहिए. We, you, and they should have meal now. Okay? The fifth rule says an objective case comes after let, like, between, and, but, except, in all the prepositions, then there has to be the objective case. For instance, मुझे ये काम करने दो. Okay? So let us here, let me do this work. Okay? The second example, उसके और मेरे बीच कोई परेशानी नहीं है. There is no problem between her and me. Here we are using me, the objective one. वह मुझ पर हंसा. He laughed at me. Me again, not I, okay? Now let's talk about the sixth rule. It says if there is a comparison between two nominative cases, the pronoun of the nominative case is used after as or then. For instance, he is as fast as me. Here, me is the objective case, which is actually wrong. You don't have to say this. You have to say he is as fast as I, okay? Because I is the nominative case, and you have to put the nominative one when we are comparing two nominative cases, okay? Now, let's go for the another example. It says, I run faster than him, okay? We don't have to use him. This is the objective one. We are comparing here two nominative cases, right? So we have to put he instead of him. I run faster than he. Let's know the seventh rule. If a sentence starts with it followed by any form of be, the pronoun that follows be must be a nominative case. For instance, it is me, which is wrong. We don't have to say me, we have to say I, because me is objective case and I is the nominative one. And here we are using it, because of which we are putting nominative one, okay? It is I who am to blame. Okay, it is him. No, not him. It is he who wants some punches. Okay, these are the, you know, most common mistakes people usually make. You don't have to do the same. You don't have to be the same. I hope this topic, the personal noun, is clear to all of you. This is way too easy and important as well. We will be meeting soon in the part 3. Till then, please take care of you guys. Be at your places and be safe.